Good morning, students. This is class 11, subject chemistry, chapter 7, equilibrium, and this is lecture number 2. These are the topics of today's lecture: reversible and irreversible reaction, chemical equilibrium, equilibrium constant, and in the last we will discuss about relation between Kc and Kp. So first is reversible reaction. So in reversible reaction, reactants converts into product and products converts into reactant. So here we will take one example where A reacts with B and forms product C plus D. In this reaction, when C reacts with product D, then it will give back A and B reactant. So this reaction is reversible in nature. Here, when AB gives C and D, the reaction is in forward direction. But when C reacts with D and gives A plus B, then what will happen? The reaction will be in backward direction. So reversible reaction, which takes place not only in the forward direction but in the backward direction under the same condition, that is known as reversible reaction. So here, this is forward reaction and this one is backward reaction. Here are few examples of reversible equation. So here iron reacts with water and gives Fe3O4, ferric oxide and hydrogen gas. Okay, when ferric oxide reacts with hydrogen, then it will give back iron and water. So we can write this equation in this way. Okay, so here we can use the sign of reversible. This is a sign of reversibility. Okay, so here iron reacts with water and gives Fe3O4 and hydrogen, and when ferric oxide reacts with hydrogen, then it will give back iron and water. Okay, so this is the example of reversible equation. Now here there is one point: if one of the product is removed from the product, then what will happen? Suppose hydrogen gas escape out, then only ferric oxide will remain left. So in that case, that reaction will become irreversible. In that case, this product will not be able to form reactant. Okay, so if one of the product escape out or we remove one of the product, then the reaction will become irreversible. Okay, now here calcium carbonate decomposed to give calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. This is also a reversible equation because when calcium oxide reacts with carbon dioxide, it gives calcium carbonate. In the same way, when N2O4 gives NO2 and NO2 gives back N2O4. Here, this is decomposition reaction. PCl5 gives PCl3 plus Cl2. So this reaction can take place in backward direction also. So these are the examples of reversible reaction. So here, note down this point: if one of the product escape out or if one of the product is removed from the reaction, then the reaction becomes irreversible. Now next is irreversible reaction. So those reaction which only takes place only in one direction. So in irreversible reaction, product do not react to give back reactants. And here are some example where silver nitrate reacts with sodium chloride and gives silver chloride and sodium nitrate. This is an irreversible reaction because here AgCl do not react with NaNO3 and gives back AgNO3 plus NaCl. That is why we are using this sign. Okay, so if reaction is irreversible, so we will use this sign. In the same way, when barium chloride reacts with sodium sulfate, it will give barium sulfate and sodium chloride. Now next topic is concept of chemical equilibrium. So here we will take a reversible reaction where A and B reacts to give C and D. Okay, this is a reversible reaction, so C and D reacts with each other and gives A and B. Now in the starting, concentration of A and B was maximum, but with the passage of time, concentration of reactant decreases. Okay, concentration of reactant decreases and reactants converts into product. And with the passage of time, more and more product forms, so concentration of product increases. So here we will plot one graph, rate versus time. Okay, rate means speed of the reaction and this is time. So with the passage of time, you will observe that rate of forward reaction decreases. Okay, because concentration of reactant decreases. As concentration of reactant A and B decreases, so it will give this type of graph. Okay, so here rate of reaction of forward reaction will decrease and this will be the curve. Now for backward reaction, concentration is increasing, so here it will give increasing curve. So this is a curve and these two curves will meet at that point, which is equilibrium. So this is the point. Okay, so this is equilibrium point. So as rate of forward reaction is decreasing and rate of backward reaction is decreasing, so a stage will come when rate of forward reaction becomes equal to the rate of backward reaction. At that stage, we will say the reaction is in chemical equilibrium. Now next is characteristics of chemical equilibrium. So first is, at equilibrium, the concentration of each of the reactant and the product becomes constant. So here is the graph between concentration and time. So with the passage of time, concentration of reactant decreases. So here you can see that concentration of reactant decreases. So this is the curve for the reactant and it is decreasing. Okay. Now with the passage of time, more and more product is formed. So concentration of product increases. So here this is the increasing curve for the product. Okay. Now, a stage will come when concentration of reactant and product will become constant. So, here you can see that at this point, their concentration will become constant. So, this is a straight line, right? So, this is the point of equilibrium. Okay, so here we will draw a dotted line and we will show that this is a stage of equilibrium. Second characteristic is, at equilibrium, rate of forward reaction becomes equal to the rate of backward reaction. That means speed of forward reaction will become equal to the speed of backward reaction. At that stage, we will say that the reaction is in equilibrium. And in equilibrium, there is continuous change. That is why we use this term dynamic. That equilibrium is dynamic in nature. Third characteristic is, chemical equilibrium can be established only if one of the product is allowed to escape out or separate out as a solid. That means if no product is allowed to escape out or separate out, only then there will be equilibrium in the reaction. If you will remove hydrogen gas, then what will happen? This reaction will become irreversible, and in irreversible reaction there will be no equilibrium. So chemical equilibrium can be established only if none of the products is allowed to escape out or separate out as a solid. Fourth is, chemical equilibrium can be attained from either direction. That means chemical equilibrium can be attained from the forward direction. That means when we are going from N2O4 to NO2. So it can be attained from this direction, or it can be attained from this direction when we go from NO2 to N2O4. It doesn't matter. Okay. Next point is, catalyst does not alter or change the state of equilibrium. We add few substance so that the rate of reaction increases, and those substance are known as catalyst. So catalyst do not affect the equilibrium. It just increases the speed of the reaction. Okay. So these are the characteristics. Now, next topic is law of mass action. I will define law of mass action later. First, we will understand what is law of mass action. Suppose there is a reaction A plus B and it gives product. Okay. Now, rate of the reaction depends on the concentration of A and concentration of B. So here, according to law of mass action, we can write that rate of reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of A into concentration of B. If concentration of A and B will be more, then that means weight, that means speed of the reaction will be more. So here, according to law of mass action, we can write that rate of reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of A and concentration of B. Here, these square brackets are representing the concentration. Okay, so you have to use only these brackets. Now we want to remove the proportionality sign. So here you will write rate of reaction is equal to K into concentration of A and concentration of B. If there are number of moles present above A and B, then you will use them in the power. Okay, and number of moles are known as stoichiometric coefficient. Okay, so this is the word stoichiometric coefficient which we use for the moles. So suppose this is the equation 2a plus 3b and it gives product. So we have to write rate of reaction for this reaction. Then how you will write it? According to law of mass action, rate of reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of A and B. So here product of concentration A and B. So you will write concentration of A into concentration of B. Now here we will write 2 in the power of A, because number of moles are 2. Okay, and here number of moles of B are 3. So here in the power you will write 3. So you will write stoichiometric coefficient or number of moles in the power. So here we will define law of mass action. The rate of a chemical reaction is directly proportional to the product of the active masses of the reactant, which is raised to the power equal to its stoichiometric coefficient as represented by the balanced chemical equation. Now next topic is equilibrium constant. Suppose we have this equation A moles of A plus B moles of B gives X moles of X and Y moles of Y. And we have to write equilibrium constant for this reaction. Now equilibrium constant is represented by Kc. Okay, capital K, and here you will write small c. Now it is a ratio of concentration of product to the concentration of reactant. Okay, and number of moles will go in power. So here for this reaction you will write concentration of X. So you will write X in square bracket because square bracket represent concentration. Okay, or we can say active mass. So here concentration of X into concentration of Y. Number of moles are small x and small y, so they will go in power. And these number of moles are known as stoichiometric coefficient. So X to the power X and Y to the power Y divided by concentration of A into concentration of B. As number of moles are A and B respectively, so they will go in power. So here we will define equilibrium constant. The product of the molar concentration of the products, each raised to the power equal to its stoichiometric coefficient, divided by the product of the molar concentration of the reactants, each raised to the power equal to the stoichiometric coefficient at constant temperature. Okay, so this is the same thing in written form. So here, if the reaction is in gaseous state, if these reactants and products are in gaseous state, then here instead of concentration you will write P. Okay, so here we are writing it for product. Product is X and Y. So as we are writing pressure of X, so here you will write this X here, okay, and power, that means number of moles will come here. So this is how you will write pressure of product divided by pressure of reactant. As we are writing it for A, so A will come here and number of moles will go in power. Same for the B. As we are writing pressure for B, so B will come here and number of moles will go in power. So formula is same. Okay, if reaction is in gaseous state, then here you will write Kp. And if reaction is in liquid or solid state, then what will happen? You will write here Kc. Okay? So in the homework, I will give you few reaction and you will write value of Kc and Kp. Now next is relationship between Kp and Kc. This is a chemical equation where A moles of A reacts with B moles of B and gives C moles of C and D moles of D. This is a reversible reaction and this is a sign of equilibrium. The reaction is in equilibrium. So here we will write value of Kp because all the species are in gaseous state. So value of Kp is equal to pressure of C. Here we will write small c in the power into Pd, pressure of D. Okay, because first we will write pressure of product divided by pressure of reactant. Here number of moles will go in power. So we will consider this equation as equation number 1. Now according to ideal gas equation, Pv is equal to nRT. So here we will find out value of P. So P is equal to N by V RT. Now N is number of moles and V is volume of solution. Now number of moles divided by volume of solution is formula of molarity, right? So here we can write N by V is equal to C. So here we will write C. So P is equal to C RT. Now for A reactant, we can write this equation like in this way, PA is equal to CaRT by using this equation. For B, we can write PB is equal to CbRT. For C, PC is equal to CcRT. For D, PD is equal to CdRT. So these are the equations and we will put value of PA, PB, PC and PD in this equation. Okay, so here we will put the values. And when you will put the values, the equation will become this. Kp is equal to this. Now, here you can see that RT is common in all the species. So here we will take RT common. Now here power of RT is C. Here power of RT is D. So here power will add up. So here we can write RT C plus D. Okay. In the denominator, here power of RT is A. And here power of RT is B. So power will add up. So power of RT will be A plus B. Now when RT to the power A plus B will go in numerator, then you will write it like in this way, that RT to the power C plus D minus A plus B. Okay, because RT will go in numerator, so here we will write negative power. So that is why here we are writing minus sign in front of A plus B. So here C plus D minus A plus B. Now we can write C plus D minus A plus B as delta NG. And this delta NG is number of moles of product minus number of moles of reactant. Now here can you see this term? C to the power C, D to the power D, A to the power A, B to the power B. We can write this thing equals to Kc. Okay, so the formula will become Kp is equal to Kc into RT to the power delta NG. So this is the relation between Kp and Kc. And this is the derivation which you have to do. So that's all for today, students. Now homework of lecture number 1 is, a liquid is in equilibrium with its vapor in a sealed container at a fixed temperature. The volume of the container is suddenly increased. So what will be the final vapor pressure and what will happen when equilibrium is restored finally? So if we change the volume, then equilibrium will be disturbed, but after some time equilibrium will be restored when rate of forward reaction becomes equal to rate of backward reaction. But vapor pressure will remain same because it depends on the temperature instead of volume of the container. Second part is, write down how initially the rates of evaporation and condensation got changed. The rate of evaporation will remain same if we increase the volume. There will be effect on condensation. the condensation will decrease initially, but after some time it will become constant. Part 3 is write down the effect observed when there was a change in vapor pressure. Now, vapor pressure depends on temperature, but when we increase volume, then initially there will be decrease in vapor pressure, but after some time, when rate of evaporation becomes equal to rate of condensation, then what will happen? It will become constant. These are the questions which you have to solve. Question number 2 and question number 4 of NCERT exercise. In question number 4, there are some reactions which are given in your NCERT exercise and you have to write value of Kc. And in question number 2, you have to find out value of Kc, concentration are given. Okay. And chemical equation is given in your NCERT book. So you have to solve these two questions. Thank you and have a nice day.